Ever wondered why Tom Brady doesn't eat foods like tomatoes, eggplants, and potatoes? Is he onto something that we just aren't? What do these foods all have in common? The latest foods in the line of fire are called nightshades. They are a family of plants that includes white potatoes, peppers, chilies, goji berries, and a few more. But can eating certain fruits and vegetables do more harm than good? In this video, we'll break down what nightshades really are, four popular myths about them, and are they safe to eat and whether or not to actually avoid them. Also, real quick guys, before we get started, it would mean the world to me if you hit the like button down below for the YouTube algorithm and turn the bell on to stay up to date with new weekly videos. Let's talk about what nightshades are and how they got their name. Now, the term nightshades may have been coined because these plants prefer to grow in shady areas and some only flower in the night. Are plants that flower in the night more harmful than those that flower in the day? Well, it goes back to a compound that they produce known as glycoalkaloids. And from an evolutionary standpoint, glycoalkaloids are designed to defend the plant against insects, predators, and thus promote the plant's survival. So it's a way that these plants fight back. And they all belong to the Solanaceae family, which consists of about 2,000 varieties of plants, most of them being inedible, like tobacco. And if you follow Dr. Joshi's holistic health plan, like Gwyneth Paltrow and Kate Moss do, which they also endorse, they claim that these nightshades may be poisonous since they are related to poison ivy, which is weird since poison ivy isn't even in the same plant family. Anyways, let's talk about the first myth. Nightshades contribute to osteoporosis. The claim is that nightshade vegetables are high in oxalic acid, which inhibits the absorption of calcium and can weaken bones and then lead to osteoporosis. But here's a problem with that. While oxalates are known to bind to calcium in the gut and reduce calcium absorption, this only occurs when calcium intakes are already very low in the body and oxalate intakes are already very high. Nightshades aren't that terribly high in oxalic acid, and if you're having a well-balanced diet, you should be fine. The second myth is nightshades are toxic since they contain the alkaloid solanine A. Yes, it is true that solanine may develop in potatoes when they are growing, which turn green when they are exposed to light, which you're supposed to toss out. Eggplants, peppers, and tomatoes do not produce solanine and are perfectly safe to eat. The third myth is nightshades worsen your arthritis pain. Now to date, there are no peer-reviewed journals that prove or disprove that they affect arthritis. The evidence is purely anecdotal. If you wanted to dive into some literature, you can find that solanine A exhibits a potent anti-inflammatory activity and that it may be a valuable leading compound in the treatment of inflammatory diseases, which is the exact opposite of what you've been told to believe. And the fourth myth is that it causes migraines. Ask any headache expert in the world if there is evidence that tomatoes, peppers, eggplants, and potatoes cause migraines. They would tell you no. But if you do want to eliminate them, to be absolutely sure, make sure you get the nutritional value from other foods because the health benefits of nightshade vegetables far outweigh any migraine risks. Now, since we went over the four myths, let's talk about if they are safe to eat. The safety goes back to solanine and how it can cause digestive issues like an upset stomach, nausea, and vomiting. But to go overboard on solanine is very rare and requires eating a large amount of young green potatoes or old potatoes with sprouts. The other edible nightshade seems to be in this pickle right here. Guilty by association to green potatoes. But it's not just solanine. Some nightshades also have capsaicin, and people with conditions like inflammatory bowel disease, indigestion, or digestive issues should avoid eating spicy foods. So you can make an argument there if you wanted. And lastly, some nightshades contain the alkaloid nic, which is why some people believe explains why we are all hooked on French fries and ketchup, which is potatoes and tomatoes, right? But the amount of nic in them is very low and nowhere near one of these. Now let's talk about whether or not you should avoid them. One exception that you can make is if you have a serious autoimmune condition or IBD. While most of the data is anecdotal, some people do report digestive problems or joint-related pain when they eat a ton of nightshades, which is why it's important to work with a dietitian to help you rule out if these are the actual causes. A food sensitivity is very patient-specific and can often be a symptom of another imbalance rather than a permanent problem with nightshades as a whole. So keep that in mind too. I don't think demonizing certain plant foods is helpful. I really don't. The last thing we want to do is scare people away from eating more plant foods when, for the most part, there really is no need to. One way to get around them, if you wish to do so, and you want to find out if they are a culprit, is swap tomato sauce and marinara for no tomato sauce using beets, swapping white potatoes for sweet potatoes, and using Italian spices like basil, thyme, and rosemary instead of cayenne or paprika. Avoid them for 4 weeks and be sure to keep track of the severity of the symptoms during that time period. But I'm more curious to hear from you guys what your thoughts are on nightshades. Let me know what they are down below. Would love to read them. In the meantime, guys, click the video I made here on cortisol-lowering foods, and I'll see you on the next one.